Welcome to my channel Glory with Mathematics. Please subscribe, like and share.
Dear students, in our last class we have discussed what is the difference between rational numbers and irrational numbers. And also we have discussed how to represent irrational numbers on a number line. Here in this section we are going to study the rational numbers and irrational numbers from a different point of view. We have to find the decimal expansion of real numbers. Then we will study what is the difference between the decimal expansion of rational numbers and irrational numbers. So here I will take an example. So this is example 5. Find the decimal expansion of one by three, 7/8, and 1/7. So we'll find the decimal expansion of these three rational numbers one by one. Then we will discuss what is the difference among them. So first, 1 by 3. So 1 by 3. So here, 1 cannot be divided by 3. So we will put a decimal sign here. So here, we will put here 0. So 3, 3 is 9. So this is 1. Again, we will put 0. 3, 3 is 9. 1, again we will put 0, 3, 3 is 9. So, like this, this will continue. So, 1 by 3, so decimal expansion of 1 by 3 will be 0.3333 up to infinity. This number 3 is repeating continuously. So, again come to 7 by 8. So, 7 divided by 8. So, 7 is not divided by 8. So, we will put here point. Here, we will put 0. So, 8 are 64. Then, 6. 6, then again we will put 0. Then, 8, 7 are 56. Then, 4. Then, again 0. Then, 8, 5 are 40. So, here remainder becomes 0. So the decimal representation of 7 by 8 is equal to 0.875. So then next, what is the decimal representation of 1 by 7? So 1 divided by 7. So here we will put decimal sign. Here we will put 0. So 7 ones are 7. So 3, again we will put 0. So 7 4 is 28. Again 2, 0, 7 2 is 14. So again 6, 0, 7 8 is 56. Then 4, 0, 7 5 is 35. Then 5, 0, 7 7 is 49. Then 1. So again this is repeating. So first, at first case our 1 is there. So from this step the block of numbers 0.142857 will repeat. So what do we learn from the decimal expansion of these three rational numbers? So here the decimal representation of 1 by 7 is equal to 0.142857. So this group of numbers is repeating continuously. So what do we observe? That the decimal expansion here in case of 7 by 8, so this terminates after 3 decimal places. But here in case of 1 by 3, the decimal numbers does not terminate. That means it is a non-terminating decimal number. But as the number 3 is repeating. So this is known as non-terminating but repeating or recurring decimal expansion. Here also, in case of 1 by 7, so this block of numbers or this group of numbers 1, 4, 2, 8, 5, 7, again this is repeating. So this is also non-terminating and repeating decimal expansion. So here we conclude that the decimal expansion of any rational number are either terminating or non-terminating repeating. So let us solve some examples. An example, show that 3.142678 is a rational number, or express 3.142678 in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. So 3.142678 is a terminating decimal number. So we can express it in the form of P by Q. So 3.142678 is equal to 3142678 divided by 1, there will be 6 zeros. So here this is the P by Q form of this decimal expansion, that is 3.142678. So here P and Q both are integers and Q is also not equal to 0. Next example, show that 0.333 can be expressed in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. So 0.333 up to infinity, it is a non-terminating recurring or repeating decimal number. So we can write a non-terminating recurring decimal number as 0.3 bar. So the number which is repeating, we can put a bar above that number. So if there is another non-terminating recurring number like this, we can here put 0.25 bar. The block of numbers which is repeating, we put bar above that group of numbers. So here we have to prove that 0.3 bar can be expressed in the form of P by Q. So let x is equal to 0.3 bar. So that is equal to 0.333 up to infinity. So this implies if we multiply both sides by 10. So 10x is equal to 3.333 up to infinity. So here compare the right side of first equation and second equation. So here 0.33 bar up to infinity. Here also 3.3333 bar up to infinity. So in these two decimal expansion, the number of digits after decimal point are same in number and they are same also. So we can subtract. So here 10x minus x is equal to 3.33 up to infinity minus 0.333 up to infinity. So this implies 9x is equal to 3. So this implies x is equal to 3 by 9, or that is equal to 1 by 3. So here this is in the form of P by Q. So where P and Q, 1 and 3 both are integers and Q is not equal to 0.